Welcome. Let's begin with the expected questions for international organizations. Now, international organizations is a very important topic. The first thing that we would take is the most favored nation status for Pakistan. Now, India has withdrawn this status. Now, under this status, which is given under WTO's GATT agreement, we are giving a special status or special preference to the goods coming from Pakistan under the treaty with 1996. And this enables us now, since we have withdrawn this, we would be hiking the custom duty on the goods which would be entering from Pakistan. So that's a very important decision that has come up in line of the Pulwama attack. The next is India-Vietnam defense cooperation. We have numerous defense ties that have come up. The most important is in the Akash missile, as the surface-to-air missile. We also have done numerous developments with Vietnam in the lines of cyber security issues. Again, we have been providing training for upgrading the Vietnamese Petra class frigates. So that's again one of the major developments that have been seen. World Economic Forum, the Gender Gap Index, which is the global gender gap report. It is a measure of gender inequality, gender equality across four pillars. Now, those four pillars are important. Those could be a direct question. So that could be economic opportunity, political empowerment, educational attainment, health and survival. Now, this has come in line. Since 2006, the World Economic Forum has come up. Ireland has been the country which has been ranked highest. India is on a 108th position that has been recorded. As we already talked about, the custom duty from the goods coming from Pakistan has been hiked to 200%. So it basically includes what all commodities. It's basically the fresh fruit, cement, petroleum, mineral ore, finished leather. So those are the major products that are coming in. India and Argentina has signed a memorandum. Now, this memorandum of understanding is across various issues. It could be across tourism, defense, broadcasting. Broadcasting has been one of the major issues that we have seen, but the most important is the nuclear energy cooperation. Now, a lot of raw material is coming from Argentina. With Argentina, we also have the Fission Moly project that has been established, or that's in line in Mumbai. It's a molybdenum project, and Argentina company InVap is working with that. So that's very important, the expertise for building a small capacity reactor. And India is having a memorandum of understanding along with the signatory members are Department of Atomic Energy and the National Atomic Energy Commission of Argentina. The next is Argentina has become or signed the framework for agreement for the International Solar Alliance. Now, International Solar Alliance is a very important topic. We have covered that separately in one of the videos. A must to know topic when we are talking about renewable sources of energy and India's target of 100 gigawatts of solar energy by 2022. So that's one of the important developments. Now, with Spain, we have come up with various rules, mainly in the democratic principles and the visionary actions for international relationship building. The economic ties have been strengthened, mainly in the field of energy, transport and railways. And we are also talking about paramilitary development. India and South Korea have again signed numerous agreements. The most important is the broadcasting system. So Korea Broadcasting System and Prasar Bharati of India have mutually exchanged ties, where each of those would be providing the broadcast in the another country. Similarly, we have a joint stamp which is known as Suri Ratna, which is a kind of legendary prince of Ayodhya who went to Korea in back in 48 AD and married the king Kim Suro. So that's a kind of agreement that was brought about with the joint stamp that has been released. So very important development in terms of investment and promotion industries. The next is India and Sweden has come across for cooperation on antimicrobial resistance. So antimicrobial resistance is one of the major projects between India and Sweden. Now, Alliance of Championship was launched by the Swedish Health Minister. This basically brings in or promotes political awareness about the leadership for antimicrobial resistance. The next is the India would be hosting the Global Digital Health Partnership Summit Now, this took place in New Delhi. The idea is to collaborate across various governments and WHO to bring in good implementation of digital health services. So, bringing in digital technology, when we say telemedicine as one of the aspects, has been important. This platform, the Global Digital Health Partnership platform, has been established in February 2018, and since then global partnership has been working. The secretariat services are provided by Australian agency for the first 18 months. RBI and Bank of Japan have signed an agreement for bilateral swap arrangements. Now this is important to improve the liquidity conditions of the country, and this basically helps to save the economy in the difficult times. Okay, so that's a major swap agreement that has taken place between India and Bank of Japan. Al Naga 3 is a joint military exercise between India and Oman. So sometimes there is a direct nationalist question, which is a joint military exercise between which two countries. However, of recent you have the detailed kind of questions that are coming up. The next is Chabar Port, which we have already discussed, which is a result of trilateral relationship between India, Afghanistan and Iran. So the Transport Internex Rotius Convention is important. It is an international convention which basically brings in administrative formalities for international road transport and brings in the movement of goods at a much smoother pace. The next is extending the financial grant to build the educational campus at Nepal. So this would be basically for the educational purpose and development of educational opportunities in Nepal. India would be India has been a long time assistance to Nepal and would be in future for fast delivery of partnership and products. Okay, the next is India and Africa's health science collaboration platform. Now African Union is very, very important here. What could be a probable question could be on African Union. So it is a continental group which is, or a continental union which includes 55 different nations. It was founded back in 2001 in Addis Ababa, Ethiopia, and then you had this African Union which replaced the Organization of African Unity. It basically aims at integrating the right global approach in the African continent. The next is India has now access to Bolivia's lithium reserves. Now India and Bolivia has come together for this lithium reserves, which is a major material for India's e-mobility and e-storage needs. So how you could get lithium carbonate and potassium chloride produced in Bolivia has been part of this. Also, Bolivia has recently joined the International Solar Alliance. So two important countries to note here, Bolivia and Argentina. Argentina, we have the nuclear ties. Bolivia, we are getting lithium, which is a major source of e-mobility and e-devices. So the International Solar Alliance has few important projects. First is the scaling solar application for the agriculture use. The next is mini grids for increasing the solar energy deployment. And the next is affordable finance at a scale. So those are some of the major developments that we have seen. We'll be coming up with many more topics, very important for your prelims examination. Before your prelims, so stay tuned. Have a wonderful day ahead.